I'm someone who has no in-between for their emotions and goes from zero completely calm to 100 explosively angry. So when I found out there was an anime that featured a character just like this, I was intrigued to say the least. I'm Truth Hero, and welcome to this edition of Philosophy Friday, as we explore the messages and lessons behind Mob Psycho 100. Mob Psycho 100 is a show that follows middle schooler Shigeo Kageyama, also known as Mob, and his adventures as an esper. Mob, along with his media mentor and boss, Arakata Reigen, try to calm upset spirits and combat psychics that use their power for evil. Which is no easy task, considering the only supernatural ability Mob's teacher has is consuming fast food. And while much could be said about the exploitative partnership with the con man Reigen, today we'll focus on the more heartwarming messages in Mob Psycho 100, those of living in the moment and always being yourself. Everything is going fine for Mob, middle schooler by day, psychic by night, but he suddenly realizes that he has no life outside of this and that his youth is just passing him by while he remains idle. He eventually joins the Body Improvement Club at his school. And what exactly is the impetus for the most powerful psychic to build muscle? Why, to become popular and impress the girl he has a crush on, of course. Huh, is that why I work out? That's right, to counter his fear of missing out, Mob plans to become the Salt Middle School definition of a man and to woo the heart of his childhood friend, Tsubomi Takane. Also known as FOMO, the fear of missing out is pretty much the opposite of YOLO. This fear can occur in our daily lives when we see others enjoying life and having rich experiences that we are absent from. This causes us to have anxiety about exclusion and wasting our precious time here. Check your Instagram and see that all your friends are at an amazing restaurant or on a fabulous vacation. The urge to comment, "Thanks for the invite," is FOMO in action. Even if it means wasting your middle school life away by snacking and playing video games in the telepathy club, Mob would still favor doing this over working for his boss, so long as he gets to enjoy his youthful time. Mob's desire for popularity and a unique niche come to a head when he's coerced into a cult meeting of people who believe that simply smiling will bring you happiness in life. The cult, also known as LOL, promise Mob that he will become popular, and, like many cults, prey on our desire to seek meaning and find a place where we belong in this world. After the cult leader, Dimple-sama, brainwashes one of his classmates and taunts Mob about not being able to show emotions like love, Mob's fears of never being able to conform are fully realized. Mob then reaches 100 on his anger scale and explodes, showcasing his true emotions and devastating psychic power by defeating the evil spirit that was possessing the cult leader and freeing everyone from the brainwashing. However, before the fight with Dimple-sama, Mob starts to realize that maybe conformity isn't such a good thing. Dimple-sama asks Mob, "Do you want to live life in a way that makes you miss out?" Mob responds with something that's funny, yet also kind of true, from his dad. While the fear of missing out or not conforming to social norms is very real, we shouldn't let other people define for us what experiences in life are rich or not. Personally, I'd feel pretty bummed if I couldn't eat sushi or drink socially with friends, but if you'd rather enjoy a day at the arcade or a picnic in the park with friends, then by all means, don't let society's bar culture make you feel as if you're missing out. If surviving a mass brainwashing wasn't enough to convince Mob that his fears are nothing and that he shouldn't conform, the anime is chock full of other references telling you to just be yourself. Heck, even the opening theme begs the question, if everyone is not special, maybe you can be what you want to be. For every But what really ties it all together is the insensitive, yet true, and loving words of Mob's mentor, Reagan. Reagan realizes that while Mob is a wildly powerful psychic, he's just a middle school boy that comes with all the complications of being an adolescent. His mentor doesn't sugarcoat it at all. He tells Mob that he's so dense and his inability to get a clue is actually rather destructive. And yet, this is why Mob was able to resist brainwashing and group psychology and was the only person suited for the task. Of course Mob can't conform. He's just a boy, and yet his sheer power and even existence don't make any sense. But as Reagan tells Mob, why do you have to conform? Why conform to laughter at middle school butt jokes, or society's standards for popularity and manliness, or heck, even just showing emotion, if it's not genuine, if you have to surrender your individuality to do so? Mob has a place where he belongs, a family that loves him, and an amazing gift as an Esper that he can use to help people. So be yourself, embrace your quirkiness, even if what makes you unique can sometimes go 100. As always, thanks for watching. Let me know if you guys want Philosophy Fridays to be a series on this channel, and I'll continue to pump out more videos and dive into philosophy. Let me know down below in the comments what you like about Mob Psycho 100 and what topics you'd like to see on Philosophy Fridays. And so you don't go 100 on your friends, click subscribe for more. Until next time. Oh, I guess Mob Psycho doesn't really have a catchphrase, huh? Well, be yourself, and you are the protagonist of your own life.